Hi, in this Lightboard session, we're going to talk about the Mule event structure, which is a key concept to understand how to pass data around your integration flow. So the overall structure, if we want to think of it in terms of buckets of data, we have the Mule event as the top level bucket. All other buckets will sit underneath that. So the first bit of data we need to think about is the message. It consists of two parts. It's got an attributes and payload. So this is set initially by whatever the listener is for your flow. So the event source will populate this based on the nature of the protocol or whatever it is that's triggering your flow. As far as attributes, you'll find things like query parameters, headers, the method, parts of the URI. So all of the stuff that gets fed across the wire over HTTP will find a home in attributes. Now, as far as payload, if the method that you're invoking this flow with has a body, so post or put or patch, then you'll find the contents of that in payload. Now, as we'll see a bit later on, we're going to need to save little snippets of data for various other uses. And we have another bucket of data called bars. So as far as our HTTP bits and pieces, we'll have things like headers, query params, and things like the method. So those all belong inside attributes. This bit here would be the HTTP body. And variables can be whatever name you like. And that is the Mule event structure, key to how you pass data from one step to the next.